I started out digging clams for a living. That's what I started doing, riding my bicycle down to the pond and digging clams. And, you know, anything that's to do with fishing business, that's what I've been doing. Where we're at here is Weekapaug Breachway, and it's just a direct shot out to the ocean. And, you know, it flows through up into Winnipeg Pond. So this farm where we're at is just ideal for growing because there's so much water flow. Oyster farming in Rhode Island is just so very important for so many reasons. The demand for raw oysters now is just overwhelming. And it's very important to Rhode Island because we have an extensive amount of area that we can put these farms. You couldn't ask for a better place. Our water quality is phenomenal, and it's just a great place to grow oysters.
You know, we had discussions between NRCS and DEM early on in 2020. We recognized that really the pressure that the aquaculture community was going to be under in terms of losing market shares and market access due to the COVID-19 pandemic, but it also thought that it may offer an opportunity that we could obtain some reproductively mature oysters that could be used in a restoration setting. Those oysters aren't usually available. They're sold at a smaller size to markets. DEM and NRCS, through our Equip Oyster Restoration Partnership, evaluated if this, you know, really the science behind it, the process behind it, and how we could implement it. And we worked collaboratively to try to find suitable restoration sites.
This year, we offered a special funding initiative through our Environmental Quality Incentives Program to fund deployment of single large mature oysters for restoration projects. This is the first year that we've done this with NRCS, and we were able to contract with growers to take these single large oysters that they had available this year and deploy those at predetermined restoration sites within Winnipeg Pond as well as some of the other coastal ponds in Rhode Island.
We were contacted by NRCS, and they had said to us, did we want to participate in an additional project other than the spat on shell project that we were involved in. It would be the deployment of single, rather large oysters. What we did was we took some of our oldest oysters on the farm that have gotten bigger than the average size that we would market. We had multiple trays of these larger oysters on the farm that we thought would be perfect candidates for this deployment of the single oysters. We brought them out to a assigned location, and we just kind of sprinkled them around on the bottom.
We'll identify where the restoration plot is. We'll mark that with buoys for them. They will come out and they'll bring their totes of single mature large oysters with them, and they will dump their totes in the water. The fall after the oysters are first deployed, as well as 2 years after that, the grower will hire a contractor to go out and do monitoring at those sites, and they'll collect some samples for disease testing. They'll do some measurements, and they will produce a report that basically documents how well those oysters are doing. And so we're using that monitoring component of the contracts to measure the success of these projects over time.
Wild oyster populations are at an all-time low. Oysters provide a number of essential ecosystem services, from water filtration to fish habitat, to in some cases shoreline protection. And so by having the oyster reef habitat absent from these systems, those services are significantly depressed, if not, you know, in some cases even absent. And so conducting oyster restoration and trying to restore some of this oyster habitat and these services is something that really can benefit everyone, whether they're concerned about water quality, just the general health of the Rhode Island, marine ecosystems, fish habitat, shoreline protection. There's really an aspect or a niche that affects everyone.
I'll tell you, I think this NRCS is, they are just fabulous people to work with, and I'm very happy to be a part of the program. I think it's a win-win for everybody, and it's very, very good for the salt ponds, and I think that it could in turn be good for the average person in the future that would be looking to go harvest wild oysters in the pond. I mean, that's really what it's all about, and it's just, it's a great program. It really and truly is.